a mask like everyone else. He was not different, and yet he fought himself as different and tried a lot to conceal his difference, his mere ordinariness, his life, which somehow, according to him, was never successful. And I think he felt ashamed of himself, because he did not succeed, because he was not this man what everyone wanted him to be. He would always read in the newspapers about stories about people who were successful, who accomplished something, and then he would always frown. I sometimes think about him sitting in the morning, bent over the newspaper, frowning. Then he would start talking. Some guy became a millionaire, made a lot of money. Someone had a great invention, accomplished something remarkable. One time I even saw him weeping after he read the story of an American Marine who saved the lives of many and was hailed and praised as a hero. And I remember the photo of this article where the Marine is applauded by many, where he is accoladed by the American president. I see vividly the photo in front of me, and I see my dad staring at the photo and weeping. He was sad. I didn't know what went on in his mind. I didn't know what was bothering him. But I saw the tears running down his cheek. This is one of the few moments when I saw the mask of my dad fall off, and he would just sit there, weep. Like maybe he thought about himself, that his life had no purpose. I don't know what people think of themselves. I don't know how people react. Or maybe some people just want to be heroes, want to accomplish something, and he did not. He would come home late night, and he would tell me all about his day. He was joyous, he was vivid. At least this is how I remember him. He would always be this man filled with a lot of optimism, filled with energy, someone who would make a room blossom. He could really encourage everyone. I remember once he talked hours about the mess in the office because one printer didn't work. I was surprised that he knew a lot of this printer, that he could tell in detail how it was structured. In retrospect, I always ask myself, did he read the manual? Did he prepare this story in advance? Or all day long when he did odd jobs, did he just think of me? Did he want to impress me and thought up this story about the destroyed printer, and he didn't want anything to leave to chance. And that's why he probably gathered a lot of information about the printer, just to impress me. Was it for me or was it for him? Did he make up this story for him? Did he want himself to hear that he's a hero, that he has accomplished something? He talked about the disarray in the office. Some of his colleagues were lost. They did not know what to do. And my dad told me he saved the day, that everything was dependent on him, even though he's only the section chief, despite that there are people who are above him, yet even they didn't know what to do. So they needed his help, and he could save them all. He showed them all what he is capable of, what he can do, what he can accomplish. I remember how he talked about it with so much passion. He talked about his love for helping people.